Namaste. In medical colleges, one of the routine scenes is students in the first year holding bones, learning their structures and parts in their attempt to study anatomy. It would be interesting to imagine the students of Acharya Sushruta keenly observing the hard white structures enclosed inside the different layers of muscles and tissues during Shavachetana or dissection of the dead body. Both these scenarios, although millennia apart, are not very different. In this video, we will be learning about osteology, that is explained in Ayurveda, detailed under Asthi Shaarira in the classical textbooks. Before we dive deep into the vast knowledge of Asthi, let us skim through the derivation of the term Asthi according to Shabda Stoma Mahanidhi. Asyate asistin, mamsabhyantare hada iti. The word asti is made of two words, as and stin. The word as represents existence and stin means to support. Mamsabhyantare denotes that the asti is confined within the soft tissues like muscles. We can also observe in this screenshot that the word os, which is the root of several terms related to bones, has similar etymologies. This gives a clue about the globalization of languages, arts, and sciences during the ancient periods, right? The synonyms of Asthi include Kikasa and Kulya, as mentioned in Amarakosha, and Haddaha and Haddi, according to Abhinava Shariram. Asthi is a heart tissue and has a predominance of Prithvi and Vayu among the Panchamahabhutas. Prithvi contributes to its Kathinya or hardness, whereas Vayu contributes to its Rukshata or dryness. Even though Ruksha Pradana, we know that bones also contain living cells and the material of bone is basically a type of collagen which is akin to kapha. According to Bhava Prakasha, Medo yat swagnina pakvam vayuna cha atishoshitam tad asti sajnyam labate sa saraha sarva vigrahe. Medo dhatu undergoes desiccation by the action of Medo dhatu agni and vayu. The Medas get transformed into asti, which is ruksha. This is responsible for maintaining the structure of the body. Vata dosha has its abode in Asthidhatu. They are inversely related, wherein when Vata dosha increases, Asthi undergoes reduction and vice versa. This negative relationship can be understood as in the case of a container and its cavity. When the cavity increases, the wall of the container thins down and becomes fragile. And when the wall of the container thickens, the cavity inside it reduces. Ayurveda also considers teeth, nails, and hair as highly related to bones. According to Ashtanga Hridaya, Nakka and Roma are mala of Asthidhatu. Bhava Prakasha mentions that Danta is the Upadhatu of Asthidhatu and Kesha as the Upadhatu of Majjadhatu. It is also understood that Asthi is one among the Pitruja Bhavas or has a paternal origin. Coming to the viewpoint of Agastya Sampradaya, the Siddhas consider Kapha energy to be located in the bones and the bone marrow. They structurally strengthen the Asthi and functionally enhance the Majja. The formation of Asthi has been again mentioned to be from Medas. This transformation has been explained analogously to how the fermentation of soft clay or mud transforms it into compact cementing material. Hence, the action of Ushnata of Agni and Vidukshana of Vayu on Meda can be said to cause fermentation and increase in density of Prithvi Bhava of Medas to form Asthidhatu. Moving to an even subtler plane, the dhatus and their respective dhatvagni have been correlated with the chakras of the human body. From the bottom up, each chakra corresponds with the seven dhatus. That is, rasa corresponds to Mooladhara, rakta to Swadhisthana, and so on. Hence, Asthidhatu corresponds with Vishuddha chakra. We know that each of the chakras corresponds with an endocrine gland based on its location. Vishuddha chakra is related to the thyroid and parathyroid glands. Do you find any relationship between these glands and Asthi? Think about it. We will learn more about it later in this video. Have you heard about Asthidhara Kala? Acharya Dalhana has mentioned in the 4th chapter of Kalpastana that Purishadhara Kala itself is Asthidhara Kala. Kala, being the kleda present between the dhatus and their ashyas or reservoirs, how can Asthidhara Kala be considered as same as Purishadhara Kala? Let us know your thoughts by commenting on this video. Let us now look into the definitions of Asthi. These definitions will encompass their explanations of structures, functions, and genesis. Tasmat chira vinashteshu tvangmamseshu sharirinam asthinina vinashyanti saranyetani dehinam. Asthi is that which continues to exist even after the decay of muscles and other soft tissues. It supports the body like the heartwood of a tree. Yatha kashtamayam rupam trinarajvopaveshtitam bhaveliptam mridabahyam tadeva dehasanyakam asthini snayubaddhani snayavo mamsalepanaha sirabhihi pushyate nityam sarvam tvachatata. According to the above verse from Kashyapa Samhita, like a structure made of wood is bound together with ropes of grass and externally plastered with mud, the body is made up of bones bound together with ligaments and coated with muscles, nourished by the vessels and enclosed by the integument. Encompassing all the ideas, Professor C.R. Agnivesh has defined Asthi as Dridaschiro dhatuhu shariradata dadatiyo mamsaganaya bandham medhobavo majjakaro asthirakyaha alambano snayusiradikasya. Asthi is a hard and lasting tissue giving support to the body, generated from medas and generating majja, providing attachments to mamsa and support to nerves, vessels, etc. Let us now move into the types of bones explained in Ayurveda. Etani panchavidhani bhavanti tadyata kapala ruchaka taruna valaya nalaka sanyani. Acharya Sushruta explains 5 types of bones. Let us look into the explanation of each one of them. Kapala asthi or flat bones. They are flat and thin bones. They include the patella, pelvic bone, scapula, cheekbone, palatine bone, temporal bone, and the bones of the skull. Rujaka asthi or teeth. Rujaka means that which is shining or glittering. The teeth are explained as bones in Ayurveda. Taruna asthi or soft bones. The cartilages are considered a softer type of bones and hence included under this classification. They include the cartilages of the nose, ear, neck, orbit, etc. Valaya asthi or curved bones. The ribs are curved and along with the vertebrae and the sternum form a protective ring in the thoracic cavity. These are included in valaya asthi. Nalaka asthi or long bones. The rest of the bones in the body come under Nalaka asthi. According to Bhava Prakasha, they include the bones of hands, feet, fingers, toes, forearms, arms, legs, and thighs. Now we will come to the enumeration of bones according to different authors. There are mainly two views in the classical texts. The Vedas describe that there are 360 bones in the body. This concept is based on the application of the Loka Purusha Samyavada, wherein the total number of days in a samvatsara is 360. Charaka Samhita, Kashyapa Samhita and both the Vagbhata Samhitas follow this line of thought. But the Vagbhatas have also honored Sushruta's viewpoint. The Shalya Tantrakaras or those from Dhanvantari Sampradaya reject above line of thought and mentions 300 bones. The later texts like Abhinava Sharira of Damodar Sharma Gaur also mentions the enumeration of bones according to the Western anatomy, which comes to 206. So, why is there such a variation in the enumeration of bones in the human body? Consideration of bone. In the current times, bones are limited to the structure, but anything that provides support, attachment for muscles and dependence on blood vessels etc. were considered bones in the ancient times. Hence teeth, sockets and cartilages were also included in this enumeration. Variations occur due to the explanations by mental contemplation only or through limited practical exposure. Observation varies with time. Now we have better modes of observation and norms of interpretation. Considering more than one bone as a single bone and parts of one bone as different bones also cause differences in the enumeration. Many bones that are separate at birth fuse together later. This variation related to age might have also played a major role in the enumeration of bones at different time periods. We may comfortably believe that there are exactly 206 bones in the adult body and around 300 bones in a newborn, as mentioned in all modern textbooks. So is this exact value correct? Check out this screenshot of the abstract of an article published a couple of years back. This reviews our thoughts and establishes that there is very less chance that a person has exactly 206 bones. That's surprising, right? We mentioned previously that Medo Dhatu Agni is responsible for transformation of Medo Dhatu into Asthi Dhatu. The pathological aspect of this can be seen clinically, where due to weak Dhatu Agni, obesity develops. This also leads to weakening and rarefaction of bones, leading to osteoporosis. The following two articles give clues about the same. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin generated in the body on exposure to sunlight. Reduced vitamin D is responsible for conditions like rickets and osteomalacia, where bone density is reduced due to calcium fixation. Calcium deficiency and bone rarefaction is also seen in lactating mothers due to the excretion of calcium through breast milk. In Asthi Kshaya, Vata Vriddhi occurs. In Ayurveda, the most important remedy for Vata Dosha is Taila, especially Tila Taila. Taila is Ushna, Guru and Snigdha, which pacifies Vata, that has Shita, Lagu and Ruksha Gunas. Tila is rich in calcium, which is essential for the health of Asthi. Moreover, Tila Taila is a Prabhava Dravya like Grita and Madhu, having undergone a high degree of transformation at a quantum level. Tila Taila has Prabhava of Surya Tattva, which makes it the most important Shamana Dravya of Vata Dosha. Hope you guys could connect the dots. We learned that Asthi Dhatu is related to Vishudha Chakra, which in turn regulates the thyroid and parathyroid glands. By observing the diagrams of metabolism of calcium, vitamin D and bone formation and resorption, it becomes evident that the Vishuddha Chakra plays a major role in regulating this. Further, we can observe that a lot of bone diseases are closely related to gut-related pathologies. This aspect is being researched in recent times. We will leave you links for some of the articles in the description box below for you to read later. But we can take the initial steps for correlation of these two by realizing that the remedy for pathologies of bones is actually tiktakshiravasti, tiktakshirapana and gritaprayoga, which has a direct influence over the purishadhara kala. That is interesting, right? With this, let us run through what we have learnt in this video. We looked into the derivations of the term asthi and also its similarities in etymology with the words for bones in other languages. Then, we tried to understand the process of formation of asthi, its relationship with vata dosha, and also the upadhatu and mala of asthi. We looked into the various definitions of asthi and understood its classification. We skimmed through the enumeration of asthi and also understood the reasons for the variance during enumeration. In the end, we spent our time with some ideas about how Asthi Shaarira is relevant clinically even in present times. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment with your opinions. Consider supporting us by subscribing to our channel and following us on Instagram and Facebook.